sabi ko, pag hindi humarap si Vicky Sara, magkakatuloy yung investigation based on kung ano yung meron na ebidensya. Pero what's next po for the investigation?
Kung ganun na mangyari, yung sabi ko nga, dumating ang December 11, wala man lang pinadatlang request for extension for valid reason or hindi man lang nagpadala ng abogado, wala, nakaantay tayo dito lahat, then we will consider that as a waiver on her part and then we will proceed with our final report.
Sir, on hold pa po ang
investigation? Continuous ang investigation, continuous, yes. Alin?
Former security.
Wala. Yes. Ah, wala. Hindi. Oo. Marami nga yung mga nag-join nga dun, including the owner of the platform. Zoom. Yeah.
Facebook.
Yung Zoom account owner. Yun. Account owner. Parang ganon. Yes. Titignan natin kung may sanction ba, pag-aaralan namin.
And this will all happen before
Yun nga, sabi ko sa inyo, pagka walang justifiable reason bakit hindi makaka-appear, we will proceed. Tapusin na namin yung investigation based on what we are holding, yung evidence na hawak namin. Pero kung may justifiable reason, we will maluwag naman tayo dyan. Hindi naman tayo nang iipit ng tao eh. Ang gusto natin yung katotohanan, maliwanaga ng sambayanan. Ganun po. Lahat ng anggulo tinitignan namin. Lahat ng anggulo pinag-aaralan namin. So, hindi pa ako makapagsabi agad ngayon na grave threat, anti-terror law, hindi pa. Depende po sa final evidence that we may gather. Yung matter of impeachment, bahala dyan ang Congress. Sila mag-iimbestiga niyan, sila ang bahala dyan. Yung aming investigation is with respect to the utterances to the threatening video clip na nangyari. Nandun lamang po kami. I don't know. Bahala sila. Hindi ko alam yung mga grounds for impeachment. No? Alam ko, pero hindi ko alam yung ano i-consider ng House. Whatever.
December 11, was it formally
relayed
to the legal counsel
on Vice President? Not yet. Sabi ko nga, within this day, pag-aaralan na namin kung ano yung isasagot namin doon sa mga request ni BP at pipilitin namin na ma-submit sa kanya, madala sa kanya at the earliest possible time para may ample time siya para makapag-aral ang kanya mga abogado.
Last two questions, please.
Sir,
ay hindi kami kasali doon sa ano sa investigasyon ng IF. Nasa house po 'yun. Eh, hindi po, ano.
Uh-huh. Thank you.
Sir, last na po. Yung possibility lang na kuhanin po ng ombudsman yung investigation niyo po, ano pong reaction niyo dun, sir?
Ano po yun?
Sinabi po kasi ni Ombudsman Martires na pwede po nilang sila yung mag-investiga, mag-take over ng investigation regarding po dito kay VP Sara. Ano po yung reaction niyo dun, sir?
Well, talagang nasa batas ng ombudsman na nag-iimbestiga na kami, but if they found out that the, for example, itong particular case na to, no, the threatening remarks was done because of her office, the ombudsman can take over. No? Pero sabi na nga ni Ombudsman Martires, it looks like yung threatening remarks na ginawa niya na yun, out of her personal capacity, hindi in connection with his office, her office, as a vice president. Parang ganun po eh.
But if mag-insist lang po sila to take over, will you cooperate, sir?
Yes. Oh, edi mas mabuti sila na mag-imbestiga na nakaligtas na kami.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
All right, the National Bureau of Investigation press briefing on the invitation for Vice President Sara Duterte to explain the supposed death threats that she made on the lives of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., First Lady Lisa Araneta Marcos, and House Speaker Martin Romualdez. The Vice President there seeking some explanation, questions, and even the NBI justifying or providing a purpose for its probe before she even agrees to attend or shed light. Now, the NBI there is saying, aside from the threats to the President, the First Lady, and the House Speaker's life, they are also investigating the very death threats that the Vice President herself received, resulting from her to react that way. NBI Director there, Jaime Santiago, also saying he will subpoena those who attended, physically attended, the Vice President's video address, particularly those who actively participated in the exchange, in the engagements there, whether people who asked questions or people who had shared their opinions during that supposed video gathering. Now, the NBI was supposed to not supposed to submit or serve the subpoena today, but the president or the vice president was supposed to attend the House hearing of the congressional hearing on the supposed anomalies at the vice president's office, but that has been postponed. Anyway, the NBI is saying December 11th, the date that they have set to summon the Vice President and ask for explanation. I will give you more updates on our succeeding newscast about this story and other developments. Please keep it here on ANC.